All right, we want to take a first look at this brand new feature inside of GA4, which are calculated metrics. So what are we talking about here? Inside of GA4, we have our reports, and they are normally made up of dimensions and metrics. And metrics are all these numbers that you see here. Now you can calculate on these metrics. What does this mean? So for example, here we have a total revenue in dollars. What if we wanted to see this in euros? Because maybe your stakeholders are calculating in euros, or your headquarters is based in Europe and you want to calculate this in euro, but your GA4 property only shows US dollars, which makes sense if this store is in the US. Well, we can calculate this now inside of GA4. All we need to do is to go over into the admin section right here. And then under the data display, we can go over to custom definitions. And there we find calculated metrics now. Now here we have the calculated metrics that you have configured. You want to configure a new one, you click on that button right here, give it a name. In our case, let's put it as euro. And then this will USD to euro. And then we need to put in a formula. Now for this formula, you have different metrics that are already available inside of GA4 that you can calculate on. So in our case, we'll go with revenue, and we have the purchase revenue right here. And then we want to multiply this with the current course for our conversion, in our case 0.94. Let's copy that and put this in right here. And then as the metric, we'll choose the currency actually. So we have this associated with currency. Now we're going to save this, and notice that you can only create 5 calculated metrics. You're already getting a warning here. And when we configure them, they are retroactive, so we can actually view them right now in our interface. We'll go back to our reports here, and previously we were looking at the traffic acquisition report. Let me change the date range, and here we have all our metrics, but our total revenue is still in US dollars. How can we add our custom calculated metric? Well, that's not possible from the interface itself. You need to customize the report. Let's click on that pencil icon, and then under metrics, you can add metrics down here. And here's our euro metric. Let's apply this. Now, if you scroll down, we see here our euro metric. So 539 or 633 and 595 euros itself. So that's a quick example of a calculated metric. Now, in order to have this in your report saved up, you can go to save button here, save the changes to the current report that we have in there. So this will make it permanent in your current report, or save this as a new report. This will put it into the library. So I'm just going to save this to our default report. And then henceforth, we should have that available inside of our normal acquisition report right here. Scroll down, we have our euros here available. So calculating metrics are a really cool addition to Google Analytics 4 to calculate on that data itself. But you don't have to take static data like 0.97 right here, because we would need to change obviously the course from time to time. You can actually take the metrics that Google Analytics 4 has available itself and calculate them together. So we can go to admin section here, and I have some examples already prepared. So under custom definitions here, we have calculated metrics. Again, these are just 5 examples because we only have 5 available. For example, inactive users right here, you have the total users, and then you also have the active users. So you can calculate the inactive users inside of GA4 by using this formula. So you are taking one metric of Google Analytics 4 and then minus the other metric of Google Analytics 4. You can choose the standard type, which is obviously just numbers. So we have this in here now, and then we have inactive users in GA4. Another example would be to have promo views per transaction. So what is this made of? Again, promo views divided by transactions, and you would get the promo views per transaction, which would make sense if you are tracking promo views with the enhanced e-commerce tracking, and you can see how many promo views do you have per transaction. We have also revenue after refunds. So if you are tracking refunds, you could take your total revenue minus the refund amount that you have already tracked. And then the unit of measurement should be currency right here. And you have your revenue after refunds. Now notice, sometimes you see a warning when you put something in. Again, this is still a new feature. Some of the formulas get this kind of warning. It is just a warning right now. You will still get the right numbers in the back end here, or view per transaction I have in here as well. Again, that's almost like the promo views. Here you're taking the views divided by transactions. So this is just an example of different custom metrics that you can choose. Now, unfortunately, the system is still a little bit restrictive. So when we go in any of these metrics, so for example here, and I start typing something, you only have these metrics available. Once you choose one of these metrics, you cannot combine them with all of the other metrics because they are maybe differently scoped. So if I would try to do ad clicks against transactions, I'm going to use these curly brackets that you need. You might get a warning, selected metrics are incompatible. So you can't always take any kind of metric and put them together. Unfortunately, this is still a bit of a restriction of the system, and I found it quite hard to replicate everything. Now, even if I go over to the help article of Google Analytics, so the official help docs, they give us some examples here, and I wasn't quite able to replicate everything that they have here because these metrics might not be available in your account or might not yet work. So shipping amount is not valid metric because it's not in that list, which should be in that list because it's listed here as one of the use cases. There's still some restrictions here, and you need to be aware that there are still a little bit of bugs inside of this new feature. And I think it's a really great addition and really something that we were missing from Universal Analytics, now available in GA4. But calculated metrics cannot only be used inside of GA4. You could also use them inside of Looker Studio through the API and obviously outside of the system if you have any other system that you work with data within. You can also in Looker Studio create calculated metrics with custom formulas. You can also send calculated metrics directly from Google Tag Manager into GA4. It wouldn't be calculated inside of GA4, but maybe before you send that data over. So inside of GTM, you could already do a calculation before you send that data to GA4. So you don't necessarily need to use that feature as it's sometimes a little bit restrictive, but it's really a great addition if you wanted to quickly put it into the system and the metrics are actually available to put your calculation together, because then you have it in the interface and it's actually retroactive. So really great addition to GA4. If you want to find out more about GA4, we have a whole playlist right here.